Freetown is a magical city. This is a beautiful, busy, cultural, economic, bustling space.
From any vantage point in the city, you're either seeing the Atlantic Ocean and the mountains, or both. But its population, it's exploded. That growth has actually impacted the forest. We lose something like 550,000 trees a year. The notion of Freetown the Treetown was to reverse the deforestation, to afforest, to regreen the city. Technology is really, really at the heart of what we're doing. Growing trees means you've got to stay there with the trees. It means you've got to protect the trees. You've got to look after the trees and monitor their growth. And that's what we do.
House building is threatening our natural ecosystems. So wherever there was forest, there are now houses. The major challenges, flooding is the biggest, landslide susceptibility, water shortages, heat stress, urban heat island effect, massive. Freetown is one of the top 10 most climate impacted cities in the world. It is the most densely populated city in all of West Africa. We have exceeded our biocapacity. We're out of balance, but it doesn't have to be that way.
Planting trees is easy. To ensure that the process is successful, what's most important is the trees don't just get planted, but grow. We have a digital platform which enables the growth of those trees to be tracked to ensure that that sustainability is embedded. And we're really excited because we've planted just shy of the 1 million trees.
But we've now set a new target. And so we'll get to at least 5 to 7 million by 2030. The app comes first. It's a very simple piece of technology that is in the hand of a community grower. You know, sort of that once they plant the tree, boom, they track it. Once they get that digital footprint of the tree and it's verified in our system, then we are able to systematically track the life and the health of the tree.
So let's say if I want to track this particular tree now, you see, I'll ensure that it fills up my camera, then I press the button in between. The process of tracking is also attached to collecting coordinates. At the initial track, a coordinate is attached to it, so it has the location of the planting. They also add a note. The note is the physical tags that we generate, and these tags are actually attached to a tree. Now, once you are done tracking, you have this dashboard. This dashboard tells you how many trees you've tracked, how many trees have been uploaded to the system. After these trees are verified, a token is issued. A token is like a coin that can be transferred from one user to another. If we need to pay growers, they have to demonstrate evidence of survival. So if you are responsible for 2,000 trees, and within a month you only grow something like 1,500, you'll only be paid for those 1,500. And that is how we are able to ensure that they provide the necessary care and support that is required to grow those trees.
The solution will need sustained investment, which is why we've moved into the development of this framework with carbon offsets.
Then now we are able to determine the carbon footprint, which then enables us to enter into the carbon market.
We create a context that leads to sustainable financing of the reforestation. What we're building here is a green circular economy. The resources that are generated then go back to the growing spaces to ensure that we can fund the reforestation. Our biggest advantage in all of this are our growers. Every tree that has ever been planted and grown is done so by those communities.
The trees are already in so many ways transformative, from the fact that they create employment, skills development for young people, economic product, because 60% of the trees are economic one way or the other. So either they're fruit trees or the medicinal trees. One of the things that is important, of course, is that we are planting indigenous trees.
We build a species mix. And so the species mix is designed to ensure that the level of biodiversity is enhanced within the context of a combination of species that are there.
I think the diversity of what we've done has made it interesting. You plant along roadsides, you plant along waterways. We have planting going on in schools, in cemeteries, in hospital compounds. As they grow up, they'll grow up into small little urban forests.
What we're trying to do, it is changing that relationship between people and nature, changing how we value it and understanding the risk dynamics associated with how we live. But if we expect people to change, we have to provide alternatives.
If we are not addressing that and just planting the trees, the rate of loss is going to be greater and the speed is going to be greater than the reforestation. To do that, we need to invest in other things. For example, in alternative cooking fuel. 82% of cooking fuel in Freetown is wood or charcoal based.
We are creating new technologies where we can get briquettes and biogas from waste that is generated from the Freetown waste plant.
It's been fascinating to have other cities come to us and say, we love what you're doing, we'd like to do it. Freetown the Treetown is the precursor to Africa Treetown. And for Freetown to be seen as a blueprint for other cities, the future city that I want to see is one where we bring nature back into the urban lived environment. There's a lot of skepticism about tree planting. So having the technology to confirm that what we're saying is happening has been very important to us. Freetown the Treetown is here to stay. And that makes me feel really, really happy.